What's up, Stock Car Spectacle fans? Nick here. So we didn't do a traditional Kinzels classroom on the show this past week, but didn't want to skip out on it entirely. We're going to get back to the traditional ways next week. But so instead, as a substitute, from both Darlington races, I picked five drivers who really stood out to me in both of those races, because these are some really exciting, really entertaining races from Darlington. So here's the top five that really stood out to me in both of these races. Number one, the 48 of Jimmy Johnson. Jimmy Johnson had a lot of speed in race number one on Sunday until he got into that wreck at the end of stage one while leading. Well, Cliff Daniels told the team, don't get down on yourselves. The car has tremendous speed. We'll be good to go on Wednesday. Well, yeah, that really showed up in Wednesday again. Now, while Johnson didn't lead any laps in that race, he still had a solid top 10 finish of 8th in race number 2. Now, Jimmy Johnson, the past couple years, we know his success has not really been there, but ever since the start of this season, it seems like Hendrick Motorsports as a whole has gotten a whole lot better. So, and it's really nice to see Jimmy Johnson in his last year be successful, sort of. I think the wins are coming at some point. Number two of the drivers that stood out to me, Tyler Reddick. Tyler Reddick was phenomenal in both of these Darlington races. And this is his first time turning laps, was going into turn one on Sunday at Darlington in a cup car. He was fast all race long in race number one, he got a top 10 finish. And then in race number two at Darlington, he finished 13th. He kind of struggled, but overall, I really think the 8 car Tyler Reddick has shown a lot of speed this year. And I think this was a perfect racetrack to show his talents and showcase it, because I think that tracks where the top line is the predominant line is going to be tracks that Tyler Reddick really succeeds in. And we really did see that in both of these Darlington races. I mean, there was times where he was cracking on the top 5 in race number 1. He didn't really get the setup going in race number 2, but still 2 tremendous finish for Tyler Reddick. He's really turning this Richard Childress Racing program around, in my opinion. Number 3, Clint Bowyer. Really, Clint Bowyer had an okay race. He had a pretty solid race number 1 at Darlington, but race number 2 is where he really stood out to me. I did not expect Clint Bowyer to be leading and winning both stages 1 and 2. That just didn't really seem like this was the track where this was Bowyer's best, but he was fast. But unfortunately, we talked about this on the show this past week. When things go right for Clint Bowyer, they don't always stay right. It's always like Jeff Gluck said it best. A Clint Bowyer race, something's going to go great, and then a piano's just going to fall on him. And that's what really happened. After dominating stages 1 and 2, Bowyer got... He spun himself around, he got a tire going down, and then his day was pretty much over. And we don't know what's up with Bowyer with his contract up at the end of the season, so it would have been really nice to see the 14 car really succeed and really achieve and do well in this race. There's still a lot of highs from that race, so, and I really didn't expect the speed out of Bowyer that we got, so hopefully that just means that the car is really fast the rest of the season, and hopefully Bowyer can put a complete race together. Number 4 on the list is the 37 of Ryan Preece. Ryan Preece, this season, he's been very solid as well. And he showed it in Darlington race number 1, where he ran in the top 10 most of the entire race, and he got a top 10 finish out of it. And then in race number 2, with the inverts, he still was able to drive his way up into the top 10 until he unfortunately had an engine go down. But I really do think that Ryan Preece has had a much better season already than his entire rookie campaign. He's been fast. He's got a couple top 10s on the year. And for that, it's good to see with that JTG Doherty race team to have cars running up front. And Ryan Preece has been doing a tremendous job, especially at a tricky track like Darlington. Darlington is a really tough racetrack. So to see a small team like JTG succeed, that's good to see for Ryan Preece. And then last but not least, the 18 of Kyle Busch. I mean, he kind of missed it in both races early on. Like Sunday, they just did not have the setup really. Then he got into some trouble. And then in race number 2, we all know what happened. He was able to run up front, but we all know what happened with the Chase Elliott incident. I think that that's been cleared up now because both drivers have commented about it. They had a phone call conversation. Chase said it went well. He thinks it wasn't intentional. And come on, guys, the ways that you look at it, everybody makes mistakes out there. Kyle Busch owned up to it and had a conversation with Chase Elliott, which was great to see. And they said the conversation went well. So honestly, in my mind, I don't think Chase Elliott's going to make it easy on Kyle Busch, but I just don't think it would make sense to retaliate, because then that is intentional right there. We know that's going to be intentional right there. I just don't think it's a smart thing to do. That was after race 6 of a 36 race season. Both of these two are really talented race car drivers. They're both going to make the playoffs. They're both going to get wins this season. So, really, I know Chase is frustrated because he's been in this situation before, but I think it was a real class act for the way that he responded to it, and I really don't see any retaliation going forward. So, like I said, this was just kind of a modified version of the classroom. Class will be fully back in session next week. So, for the Stock Car Spectacle, I'm Nick Kinzel. Make sure to follow us on Twitter, Instagram, subscribe to our YouTube pages and our Anchor page, and just really watch us on all podcast platforms. We'll see you next week.